Hi, my name is Navya and today I'm going to talk about single women and different marital status and how does it impact her social well-being. Teach your daughter that coming home from a failed marriage is better than coming home in a coffin. This quote has made a significant impact on me and has made me question the institute of marriage. In India, a man and a woman don't get married. Rather, the families get married. And women are the only ones responsible to keep the marriage, no matter what. And in times of divorce, women are often criticized for not being able to keep it. People say that their in-laws just get on her and they just talk about her. Marriage in India, especially for women, is given prime importance because she's considered to be incomplete without it. Some people say, according to the ancient Hindu scriptures, it said that a wife is a adhargini, which means half of a man. And for single women, it's very hard to be in this society. You know, if a single woman or a divorced or a widow or anything like that is present in a social gathering, then people call her out. People be like, oh, well, you're out here partying. What about your family? Why aren't you patching your family? Or if she's a widow, people call her out being like, you don't have any grief for your husband passing away. And single mothers are often questioned on how they will raise their child. What type of values are they going to impart? And most of it actually is that she will never be able to be good enough to fill the gap. And there is always going to be this incomplete part. And the child won't be as good enough. And we live in a patriarchal society, which means that men hold dominance of moral authority and political leadership. It's all under their control. And it's very hard for women to seal their assets. And with these, women have economical problems. But that isn't the worst. The worst problem here is what society tells them. It's the questions that are on them. And through my research, I found the concept of singleism very fascinating because I felt singleism is more about empowering your soul, but people are just rejecting getting married and they just don't want to. Women today feel that their independence is more important and they have commitment phobias. And with this, it's just that men and women are lonelier than ever. They don't have anybody to share their feelings with. They just don't have anybody. They don't even have kids now that they're not married. And if they aren't married, then having a kid is basically against the norms. And a society moves in pairs. So we don't have a society wherein everybody is just included. And I feel that it's okay to be single, but getting married is very important. And it's important that we join our hands to raise awareness about single women. I feel that if institutions today join hands to put out social and political policies, then these things can really be stopped. And I feel that not only women should be taught about how to deal with divorce and such cases, but also men should be the one to take initiative to solve problems. Not only this, but I'd say, let's just join hands, come up with new solution. And I think that today, change is required at a micro level as well, at all levels, to be honest. Macro and micro level, it's very important for us. So let's make a change out there. And let's hope that all single women get equal rights as men. And we don't judge them based on who they are, because we all are important. Thank you so much.